Hello, good day. We are here in our lab in Italy, and today I wanted to talk about conching. Why so? Because there are many reasons to do conching, and there are many ways to do conching. And I would like to share our experience as manufacturers and users of machines. So first of all, what is conching? Conching is a step of flavor development and a step of improvement of the viscosity of the chocolate, a reduction of the viscosity of the chocolate that takes place after refining, and that has many implications for the definition of your chocolate. First of all, viscosity. Viscosity is very important for the use of the chocolate in tempering and robing, or any other use that you have of your chocolate. But also viscosity affects the perception of the flavor, because if the chocolate is too viscous or too fluid, the perception in the mouth will be different. So controlling the viscosity, and in particular for chocolates like the bean to bar chocolate without added lecithin, and sometimes even without cocoa butter, the viscosity can be extremely high. So a step of viscosity reduction during conching is extremely important. So first of all, let's go one step back. Refining. We are here with one of our low speed ball refiners. During refining, we have two devices that we turn on this machine, that are the extraction of acidity, which is a blower that during refining is removing the volatiles present in the chamber, in the free part of the chamber, of the milling chamber. And in second, as a second point, we also have an inlet of hot air. Why this, and what is the result of this? So first of all, eliminating humidity from especially from cacao allows to reduce the viscosity, because moisture is a powerful it's a powerful thing to increase viscosity. So if we get rid of as much humidity as we can reduce the viscosity already with that. Second point, by injecting and also the extraction of humidity allows to extract the strong volatiles that create during refining. And this is a kind of a pre-step of conching, as well as the inlet of hot air allows a previous step of flavor development during refining. But coming back to a conch, we found out that with our refining system, at the end of refining, the chocolate can be particularly thick. So low speedball refiners are really powerful tools to have great productivities and to have the perfect smoothness for your chocolate. But the finer is your chocolate, the thicker it can be and more viscous. So our conches, apart the devices for the flavor development, which are the acidity extractor, the inlet of hot air, the recirculation of the chocolate bottom to top, apart these devices and apart the heating and the cooling and the slow stirrer that is producing a thin film of chocolate on the double jacketed chamber, apart that we have a device on the conches that we call the shear stress device. This is a device that is stressing mechanically the chocolate without impact. But basically what this tool is doing is scraping from the surface of the particles the excess of cocoa butter that surrounds them. And by doing this, we are releasing a part of this cocoa butter trapped on the surface of the particles. You have to imagine that the particles of sugar, of even dry cacao, milk powder, they are not smooth like stainless steel. They have a surface that is that has what technically is called a rugosity. So they have peaks and valleys, and a lot of cocoa butter is trapped there. So by providing this mechanical action of shear, we are releasing part of this cocoa butter. And what we have found out about our conches is that after 6 hours, we have a release of cocoa butter corresponding, in terms of reduction of viscosity, corresponding to adding from 2 to 4% additional cocoa butter. This is a game changer. And this reflects on the usability of your chocolate, especially if you do 2 ingredients chocolate, but not only. So in conching, apart flavor development is extremely important, also the reduction of viscosity. So why do we use, this is our smaller model before we were watching the 250 kg model. Why do we use vertical rotary conches? We do because we have tested different technologies when we were designing our process. And we found out that horizontal conches, like for example this one, which is our small 10 kg prototype of an horizontal conch, they are really good in flavor development. So we have them among the machines that we manufacture, horizontal conches. But we found out that the reduction of viscosity is either absent or much, much slower. Why so? Because while for flavor development an horizontal conch by pushing up the chocolate and making it get in touch with the atmosphere is very good for releasing volatiles, which is something that we achieve on the vertical conches with the pumping of the chocolate from the bottom to the top and with the inlet of hot air, we found that in the horizontal conches, apart this thing, consider that our horizontal conches have an acidity extractor, an inlet of hot air as well. Apart the flavor development, missing this shear stress device that we have and we can only have on vertical conches doesn't allow an improvement of the viscosity, at least not visible. And in case for some recipes this happens, it's 3 times slower. So whenever we say that we think that the vertical conches applied to ball mills are better, we are saying that because as all of the things that we propose, we have tested it and we have optimized it. So our conches have a PLC and a touch screen where you can program 4 conching phases and you can control all the parameters from temperature, to speed, to what have to have on and off depending on the phase. So at the end of the working day, you can just program your conch and it will work alone, and in the morning you will get your chocolate perfectly fluid and with the flavor that you want. How long does conching last? It depends. It depends on your recipe. It depends on your cacao. It depends on your taste. So there is no law of God on how long should conching last. We can say that averagely it lasts from 6 to 12 hours, and some of our customers even do 24 or 48 hours. So all of this is to describe what we do and what our machines do. Plus, there are some add-ons, like this tool here, which is our aromatizer. You can load in here anything that you want to add as a flavor, like for example orange peel or mint leaves or cinnamon or anything physical, and simply by putting these items inside this container, the hot air blower will blow the flavor in the chocolate, and it will be an aftertaste in your chocolate, which is not going to be an additional ingredient. You are just blowing its flavor in. And of course, we have the opportunity to also have an automatic download. Let's say that you want your chocolate to be in the morning into a tank. We can put an actuator in here on this three-way valve and have the download directly in your tank or wherever you need the chocolate. Finally, an important point that we need to underline. There are some other technologies that propose conching before refining. Basically, they in general, this happens with horizontal conches. You load the cacao, the pre-refined cacao, the sugar, and you let it blend with the horizontal shaft for several hours to remove the volatiles and to remove even humidity. And this is, I don't say it's bad for the chocolate, it's okay. But if you do conching before refining, when you are breaking, in particular, the cacao particles from their size, that for a pre-refined cacao can be from 200 to 150 microns to 50 microns, when you break them during refining and you bring them down to 18, you are increasing the surface of these particles. You are increasing because simply when you have a spheroid, like a solid particle is, and you break it, you are increasing by cracking it, you are increasing the surface of these particles. And the surface is where the flavors are coming from, the off flavors as well. So the increase of the total surface by bringing cacao down from 150 microns to 18 microns is dramatic. And so you did the conching before refining, then you do refining and you get more humidity, acidity, off flavors, and you are also getting more surface. So more surface that sucks free cocoa butter. So your product will be, I don't say as if it didn't do any conching, but absolutely not complete in its flavor development, because you added more acidity and more humidity, and it will be extremely viscous. So doing conching before refining, at least in our experience, does not work. The traditional process of chocolate is refining, and then conching. And this is what we propose to our customers, and what we have tested in this lab, measuring the viscosity of the chocolates and tasting the different chocolates coming from the traditional process or this alternative process, which we don't like. We propose a process where the refining and the final particle size distribution is achieved, and only then we do conching in one of our conches. Then it can be horizontal, it can be vertical. But when you blend sugar and cacao before refining, it's not called conching, it's not called dry conching. It's called mixing. Dry conching is something completely different, and it's applied to the other technology to make chocolate, which is roll refiners. Roll refiners are fantastic. They are just very expensive and to buy and to maintain, and they are not affordable for everyone. The ball mills, low-speed ball mills like those we manufacture, they allow to have really the same particle size distribution measured. We have several tests that can prove it. The same particle size distribution of a raw refiner, it's just a machine who is cheaper and more affordable and less expensive even in maintenance, rather than raw refiners. So the only big difference is that with ball mills you cannot achieve the same productivities of raw refiners. So a raw refiner can make you up to 4 or 5 metric tons per hour. Ball mills cannot get those productivities, and in particular we manufacture low speed ball mills because this is providing a better treatment to the chocolate with no metal contamination and no overheating. But when you do conching for ball mills, you have to do it after. Otherwise your product won't have a perfect flavor, and your product will be extremely, extremely viscous. If you have any question about our machines, about conching, about refining, and about the other steps, please send us a message or send us an email. Thank you very much, and have a good day.